based on multiple. Least upper bound is something similar to this. See, least common multiple. So, suppose I have the numbers 12 and 16. So, what are the multiples of 12? These are 12, then 24, then 36, okay, then 48, okay, like this, then this is 16, and what are the multiples of 16, 16, then 32, then 48, these are the multiples of 12 and these are the multiples of 16. Okay. If you compare these multiples, in general they are different. Okay. 12, 16, 24, 32, 36. But at some stage, you may get a common multiple. Okay. So there are other stages also where you may get a common multiple. Something like 480 and something like 250. At some other stage also you will get some common multiple. Okay. So there are lots of common multiples. Onekulas common multiple. Okay. There is no any multiple of 48 is actually a common multiple of 12 and 16. Okay. But out of all these common multiples, which is the least? 48 is the least. Okay. So that is why this is called the least common multiple. Okay. So least common multiple of 2 numbers has to be a multiple first. So my multiple will be left. It has to be a multiple of both 12 and 16. And so under what condition you will say that D equal to LCM of AB. Under what condition you will say D should be a multiple of D is a multiple of A and B both. And the second condition is, means if I have any other multiple, if I have any other multiple, say E, then what should be the relation between D and E? If E is any other multiple, common multiple of A and B. Suppose E is any other common multiple of A and B, then what should be the relation? D should be less than or equal to. Okay. This is the concept. Right. D is a common multiple of A and B, and if somebody comes up with any other common multiple, then D should be less than or equal to. Okay. Then I can say that D is the least common multiple. Both same concept are taken out of least upper bound. Okay. If suppose alpha is an upper bound, of A. Suppose alpha is an upper bound of A, and I want to define alpha to be least upper bound. Okay. LUB. So two conditions should be satisfied. First condition is alpha should be an upper bound of A, and number two condition is, If beta is an upper bound of A, then what should be the relation between these two? Alpha should be less than or equal to. Okay, because alpha is the least upper bound. Okay. So out of all the upper bounds, alpha will be the smallest. So this is actually the definition of least upper bound. Okay. So we will write it nicely. How to define least upper bound using this concept, least common multiple. So the definition is this: a real number alpha is said to be bounded above itself. Capital A. If number one condition is alpha is an upper bound of A. Yeah, that is x less than or equal to alpha for all x inside. What is the meaning of this? This means that alpha is an upper bound. Alpha is an upper bound. So first condition is every element of A should be less than or equal to alpha. Okay. First thing is that alpha should be an upper bound. So every element of A is less than or equal to alpha. And the second condition is if beta is an upper bound, is an upper bound of A. Upper bound of A. Then alpha is less than or equal to. So if any real number will satisfy these two conditions, is called the least upper bound of the bounded above set capital A. Okay, this is the definition. So in last class we have seen a set may have many upper bounds. Any set may have many upper bounds. Okay, but here you see in the definition I have written is said to be the least upper bound. Okay, so I have written this because it can be shown that the least upper bound is unique. Okay, there is only one list. There cannot be more than. There cannot be two tigers in the same forest. You must not get that. Otherwise they will fight with each other. Okay. It's the same. There are too many tigers. Each tiger or two lions in the same place. Each lion has its own idiom and idiom. Okay, so this least upper bound also, there cannot be two least upper bounds of a set. Okay, we will prove this. It's a very simple proof. Okay. And so this is what. So let us see that least upper bound. So let us try two problems. One problem is this one. Bounded above set. So we start with this. Suppose alpha and beta are two least upper bounds. So suppose you start calculating and after calculation you come up with an upper bound alpha, least upper bound alpha. Okay. Your friend calculates and comes up with the least upper bound beta. Okay. In the examination, if you get two different answers, then at least one of you have made mistake. Okay. Least upper bound will be always unique. So if see, so if I claim that this is the least upper bound, then what should be the relation between alpha and beta? Alpha? No, suppose I do not know now that these two are equal. Okay. Suppose first I consider this as the least upper bound. Okay. And this is also a least upper bound. So first of all, it has to be an upper bound. So this is the least upper bound. This is an upper bound. So relation between them is this: alpha less than or equal to. Next, this is also the least upper bound we have claimed, and this is an upper bound, so beta should be less than or equal to alpha by definition. Okay. So we will get something like alpha less than or equal to beta and beta less than or equal to alpha. So then that is possible only when alpha and beta are same, equal. Okay. So with beta line lateral about each other. So suppose, so from here are two upper bounds. Okay. So now, so alpha and beta both are upper bounds. Upper bounds. Upper bounds of K. Alpha and beta are both upper bounds of K. So since alpha is least upper bound. Least upper bound. And beta is an upper bound. So again, alpha should be less than or equal to beta. Since alpha is least upper bound. We have already supposed that alpha is a least upper bound. Okay. So since alpha is a least upper bound and beta is an upper bound, so this should be satisfied. Alpha should be less than or equal to beta. Okay. Also, since beta is least upper bound, this upper bound, and alpha is an upper bound. Bound. So the definition also gives that beta should be less than or equal to alpha. Right. Okay. So we are resolving the issue now. The issue is two persons have come up with two different list of bounds. Okay. So we are resolving the issue now. Okay. মানলাম আচ্ছা তুমি নিয়ে আইছো একটা এটা হলো তোমার লিস্ট আপার বাউন্ড হে যারা নিয়ে আইছে এটাও আপার বাউন্ড সো আলফা লেস দ্যান ইকুয়াল টু বিটা হইতে লাগে ওকে তারপরে মানলাম আচ্ছা হে যারা আনছে এটাও লিস্ট আপার বাউন্ড ওটা বিটা আরেকজন যারা আনছে দ্যাট ইজ আপার বাউন্ড সো বিটা লেস দ্যান ইকুয়াল টু আলফা হইতে লাগে দ্যাট মিন্স বোথ দিস টু শুড বি স্যাটিসফাইড এন্ড বোথ দিস টু উইল বি স্যাটিসফাইড অনলি আন্ডার ওয়ান কন্ডিশন আলফা ইজ ইকুয়াল টু বিটা ওকে দিস টু আর সাইমালটেনিয়াসলি ট্রু অনলি আন্ডার ওয়ান কন্ডিশন So from 1 and 2 we have alpha is equal to beta. So from 1 and 2 from 1 and 2 we have alpha is equal to beta. So the least upper bound is unique. The least upper bound is unique. So very simple proof. Just some arguments. Okay, logical arguments. Which one is creating a confusion? Alpha is least upper bound, beta is an upper bound. So their definition says that alpha should be less than or equal to beta. Similar thing applies here. So this is the. So similar to this concept, we will also define the greatest lower bound.
Alpha and beta
are lower bounds of it. Are lower bounds of it. Since they are greatest lower bounds, so they are lower bounds. So just use the same argument. So now alpha is greatest lower bound. Greatest lower bound. And beta is a lower bound. And beta is a lower bound. Lower bound. So what should happen? The relation here. Alpha is greatest lower bound, beta is a lower bound. So which one is less? Beta. Beta is less. Beta is less than or equal to alpha. Okay. Beta is any other lower bound, and alpha is the greatest lower bound. So beta should be less than or equal to alpha. Okay. Number one. Then your again. Beta is greatest lower bound. Greatest lower bound. And alpha is a lower bound. Alpha is a lower bound. So alpha should be less than or equal to beta. Okay. So it was true. So from 1 and 2, we can come to the conclusion that alpha is exactly equal to beta. So from 1 and 2, 1 and 2, we have alpha is equal to beta. So greatest lower bound of a bounded below set is unique. Okay. Now there is a property which guarantees that a bounded below set will have a greatest lower bound. So that property is called this bounded above set will have least upper bound. Okay, that property is called the LUB property of the set of real numbers. Okay. So it's a property which is taken for granted. This is an axiom. Okay. Axiom for the so mathematics has certain gods. Okay. We do not question the existence of these gods. One of them is called well-ordering principle. In the set of, if you have a set of positive integers, you can always find the smallest value. Okay, we have no proof. Nobody has been able to prove it. Okay. So these are taken as gods of mathematics. They are taken as granted. That yeah, it is true. Okay. We assume that it is true, and then we do all the mathematics. Okay. So this LUB property is also something like that. We take it for granted that least any bounded above set in the set of real numbers will have least above. Okay. So that is called the LUB property of R. So what is that LUB property or least above bound property? LUB property or this is also called completeness axiom. LUB property of the set of real numbers. Okay. Of R. Any bounded above set in R has the least upper bound in R. Every or every non-empty bounded above set. So every non-empty bounded above set in R has the least upper bound in R. the least upper bound property of R, or the completeness axiom. Also about completeness. Completeness. And corresponding to this, there is another property which can be derived from this. Okay. That is also called GLB property. Okay. GLB means the greatest lower bound. Okay. GLB property. So we don't have to assume both. If we assume one, this is obvious. Okay. So let me just mention it. GLB property of R. Okay. So what is that? Every non-empty bounded below set in R has the greatest lower bound in R. This is what we will take. Every non-empty bounded below set. Every non-empty bounded below set in R has the greatest lower bound. Greatest lower bound. Non-empty bounded below set in R has the greatest lower bound in R. This is the GLB property.
Let
this is equal to beta. Suppose this is alpha, this is beta. Then what do you have? Then every element of A is less than or equal to alpha. So then x less than or equal to alpha or all x inside A. Okay. Alpha is least upper bound of A. Okay. That means alpha is an upper bound of A. So every element of A will be less than or equal to alpha. Okay, this is true. Right. And so can I say that every element of B is also less than or equal to alpha? It has quasi-unit property. Huh? Every element of A is less than or equal to alpha. This is known to us. Can I say that every element of B is also less than or equal to alpha? Huh? Chinta karo. B. What is the relation between B and A? B is a subset of A. Okay. So B. The elements of B are actually elements of A. So we can say that x less than or equal to alpha for all x in B also. Okay, if you take an element from B, it is actually an element of A, and every element of A is less than alpha. So from here we can write less than alpha. And since beta is B is a subset of A, so we have x less than or equal to alpha for all x in B. B is a subset of A. So every element of the bigger set satisfies this. So every element in the smaller set will satisfy this. Right. So from this line, what can you say? X less than or equal to alpha for all X belongs to B. From this line, what can you say about alpha? Any real number which satisfies this sort of condition is called what? Of the set B. See nicely. This alpha will be called what of the set B? Every element of B is less than or equal to alpha. That means alpha is a what? Alpha is an upper bound of B. Okay. So from this line we can write, hence alpha is an upper bound of B. Because every element of B is less than or equal to alpha. Is an upper bound of B. But what is the least upper bound? Is it B least upper bound of the beta? Okay. But beta is the least upper bound. Least upper bound of B. Upper bound of B. Okay. So what should be the relation between them? Just go by the definition. Beta is the least upper bound of this set, and alpha is an upper bound. So what should be the relation between them? Beta is the least upper bound, and this is any other upper bound. So beta should be less than or equal to alpha. Okay. So what do we have? That is, what is beta? Beta is nothing but least upper bound of B. This is less than or equal to least upper bound of. So when you write B and beta in the same problem, please remember to extend B. This is beta. Okay, this is beta. So just make this difference. Otherwise, it will seem same. Yeah. Or if you are finding it difficult, you can write it as alpha 1, alpha 2. Or say any other thing, x, y, not necessarily Greek letter. You can write anything English. Yeah. Don't write manually. So if you have a subset, then least upper bound of the subset is less than or equal to least upper bound of the bigger set. Okay. So can you prove the similar thing for this? Then prove that greatest lower bound of B is, what do you think? Determine the less than or equal to even. Greatest lower bound of B will be less than or greater than. Just see that example 1, 2, 3, 4. In this case, what is the greatest lower bound? Greatest lower bound is 1. No? Greatest lower bound of this set is 1. But greatest lower bound of, suppose I take this subset, 3, 4. What is that? That is 3. Okay. So greatest lower bound of the subset may be larger. Greatest lower bound of the subset may be larger because the whole set is obtained by including some more elements. So when you include some more elements, it may happen that you have included smaller elements. So so here actually it will be greater than original. Okay. So let A be a bounded above set. Oh sorry. Let A be a bounded below set. Let A be a bounded below set. And phi not equal to B subset of A. Okay. That means B is a non-empty subset of A. Okay. Then prove that greatest lower bound of B is greater than or equal to least. Sorry. Greatest lower bound of B is greater than or equal to greatest lower bound of A. Okay, this one. Right? This. So the proof is exactly similar. Proof is exactly similar, just here you will have x greater than or equal to alpha for all x. Okay. Then you will have x greater than or equal to alpha for all x in B. That means alpha is a lower bound of B. But beta is the greatest lower bound. So beta will be greater than or equal to alpha. Okay. Exactly similar type of proof. You please try it later. So we are almost at the end of this unit. Next day we will do Archimedean property of real numbers. Okay.